It was uranium that first proved the existence of radioactivity in experiments conducted in the late 19th century. It took another 30 years or so to show exactly how dangerous radiation exposure was to humans, though. So with that in mind, what would happen if these extremely toxic substances were actually ingested? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what would happen if you ate uranium? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. Uranium is a naturally occurring chemical element sought after for its unique nuclear properties. It's actually one of the easiest elements to get your hands on. Not that you'd want to get your hands on it without some protection. There are some important discrepancies to make, though. Natural uranium mostly consists of the isotope uranium-238, which is non-fissile, meaning that it cannot sustain a nuclear chain reaction. However, it can be transmuted into plutonium, which is fissile. About 0.7% of natural uranium is uranium-235, which is already fissile. The term enriched uranium refers to uranium with an increased percentage of this isotope thanks to the removal of other isotopes. Infamously, uranium was the key ingredient in Little Boy, the nuclear bomb the United States dropped on Hiroshima in August 1945. And it was also used in the Tsar Bomba, the Soviet bomb that still holds the record as the most powerful nuclear weapon ever detonated. Furthermore, one byproduct of using uranium in nuclear reactions is another volatile isotope, cesium-137, the isotope that made the Chernobyl disaster of 1986 so dangerous. It was cesium that created the radioactive fallout that ended up spreading around the world. We know then that there are massive risks at play with this particular substance. People who work with uranium on a regular basis need to wear protective suits, though even this isn't a perfect solution against ionizing radiation. All kinds of measures are taken in uranium mining to protect workers, like mitigating how much dust they're exposed to and regularly checking what dose, if any, of harmful radiation they've been subjected to. Although we can now limit the danger uranium poses to people who work with it on a daily basis, then, those people are still strongly advised not to ingest any of the naturally forming uranium isotopes found in the ground. In short, do not eat it. But what if you did? And maybe not for careless or reckless reasons either. Perhaps uranium just gets into your food or water accidentally, since uranium mining has been noted to release dangerous contaminants into the surrounding environments. For example, there have even been incidents where vegetables have become contaminated if they're grown in close proximity to mining operations. Thankfully, studies also show that the amount of uranium exposure one would get from consuming it in this way is negligible. It doesn't pose an immediate health risk. But of course, that doesn't mean we shouldn't still protect against it. After all, even in its non-isotope form, uranium is still a radioactive metal. Nevertheless, when it comes to uranium being inside your body, how much you should worry really depends on how much there is, on how much you, in this case, eat. Unsurprisingly, the human body isn't designed to digest uranium in any form, but there are some that can be easily taken in. Yellowcake is a bright yellow uranium concentrate produced in a powder. It's what's eventually used to create the uranium used for fuel from the unprocessed uranium ores found in the ground. And as well as being mildly radioactive, it also smells unpleasant. It clearly wouldn't be appetizing. But even if you were to smell it, then you may well inhale it, which is equally ill-advised. If it's in your system, however it got there, your biggest, most immediate problem is going to be kidney damage. Your kidneys are responsible for filtering your blood and creating your urine out of the waste products your body doesn't need. And broadly, if anything happens to your urinary system, you're in big trouble and perhaps in need of a kidney transplant or dialysis. Because your kidneys definitely can't process and filter uranium properly, they're the first to be affected by the fact that you've ingested it. Even if uranium gets directly into your blood, such as via depleted uranium bullets, you're still going to suffer kidney symptoms first. Having said that, such bullets actually have very little radioactivity and therefore aren't generally considered a nuclear weapon. Still though, around 99.5% of any uranium you ingest will be passed through your digestive system, with 0.5% being absorbed into your body. It can reside in your bones for weeks to years, and through repeated exposure, the amount of uranium in your bones increases. Your brain can even be affected eventually. If you ate and kept eating natural uranium, then you're going to have a lot of issues, at a level way beyond any uranium exposure you'd get from just working with it or living in an area where it's mined. you'd essentially be giving yourself kidney failure. Even if, on the dullest of bright sides, there's not any evidence that exposure to natural uranium causes cancer. However, this is only naturally occurring uranium. History shows that with processed uranium, it's a very different story. Uranium ores in the ground go on to be processed and enriched, creating dangerous isotopes which can definitely cause cancer. Again, it was uranium in the bomb dropped on Hiroshima. The bomb dropped on Nagasaki days later, Fat Man used plutonium, which is synthetically produced from uranium-235. And the cancer rates of survivors of both bombings significantly increased in the decades after 1945. Depending on the precise circumstances then, the risk of cancer is still very real. If you're eating volatile radioactive isotopes, be they uranium isotopes or even more dangerous ones like cesium-137, you're going to get into a lot of trouble very quickly. More specifically, cesium-137 will continue to release large amounts of beta and gamma radiation while it's in your body, potentially causing radiation sickness in the short term. If you were to literally eat it, then all of that would be absorbed into your blood and will then be spread around your body, notably to your muscles. The immediate symptoms of radiation sickness, also known as acute radiation syndrome, primarily include nausea and vomiting, including the vomiting of blood. And eventually, if you have a large enough dose of radiation, about 30 grays, you're going to develop something called cerebrovascular syndrome, something humans can rarely, if ever, survive. Once those symptoms appear, which include tremors and seizures, death follows in 2 days at most, but usually a lot quicker. Even at lower doses, you can also develop conditions that lead to the collapse of your circulatory system, lethal blood poisoning, and anemia. Supposing you do manage to survive, the effects will nonetheless remain with you forever, as your chances of getting thyroid cancer or leukemia hugely increase. Once more, the only silver lining to all of this is also quite a dark one. The good news is that naturally occurring radioactive substances like uranium will never provide a high enough dose of radiation to cause radiation sickness like this. But that means that if you were exposed to these levels of radiation, it would always be as a result of some kind of disaster, either a nuclear power plant disaster like Chernobyl or Fukushima, or exposure to nuclear bomb explosions like a nuclear attack or nearby nuclear tests. Remember, in the 1950s and 60s, nuclear weapons were often tested near populated areas. The notorious Nevada test site just outside Las Vegas operated for years, and the fallout it created traveled all the way to Utah, where it's been noted that cancer incidence and mortality have both increased. Luckily, nuclear tests like this are no longer conducted, so if you were ever at risk of developing radiation sickness today, you'd certainly know about it quickly, because you'll have to have been close to a major incident, like a bombing or a meltdown. For now, eating natural or depleted uranium just isn't advisable. While it's unlikely we'll ever stop mining uranium, because it's so crucial in modern nuclear technologies, we do need to remain careful about it. If you live near a uranium mine and are scared you might have accidentally eaten trace amounts of the stuff, you will likely be okay. But it's still something we should all try to keep out of our diets as a rule. We know and have seen the damage that it can do, and that's what would happen if you ate uranium. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.